sign, guide us in your path, that we may walk in your truth, glad in our hearts that we may fear your holy name. For you are great and your wonders, only you are God, the Lord, and there is none like you among the gods. You are great in mercy, gracious in strength, and in the aiding and exhorting and saving all those who place their hope in your holy name. For to you alone, all glory, honor, and worship, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, and the Lord, the age of ages.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Set free all our senses from deadly passions. Send over them as a good guide the understanding that is within us. Let our eyes abstain from evil sights, our hearing from idle talk, and our tongue cleansed from unsuitable speech. Purify our lips that sing your praise, O Lord. Let our hands abstain from evil acts and produce only works that are pleasing to you, safeguarding by your grace all our lives and mind. For to you, O Lord, our words, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, not for the age of the nature. Protect us, O God, by your grace.
Mercy.
We the Son, and our God, through the awesome mysteries offered here. And when you have freed us and your faithful people from all impurity, sanctify our souls and bodies for the sanctification not to be taken away, so that with a clear conscience, impress us without shame, and enlightened heart, and participate in these divine sacraments. Through them we are given life that we may be united to your Christ, your God, who said, what breathes my flesh, drinks my blood, abides in me, and I am. So your word, O Lord, abide in us and walk in among us, and become temples of your all holy, worshipful spirit, having freed from every diabolical device, whether by deeds or words or thoughts. Thus shall we obtain the blessing you have promised us, go the earth with all your saints, and from all ages that will please you. And grant us crowns with boldness and without condemnation, to dare by the heavenly God, Father, and to say,
among us.
Save, O God, your people, and bless your heritage close to us, belongs to give glory to the one maker of the Holy Ghost,
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Good evening, Kalispera again. My brothers and sisters who are with us in spirit, as we are in the final week of Holy and Great Lent, the sixth week of Holy and Great Lent. Again, a Lent like another we've ever had. And yet it is still, despite us sheltering at home, it still, as I've mentioned before, can bear great spiritual, we still can bear great spiritual fruit, because we are called to overcome the passions during Holy and Great Lent, to shed those things that do not belong in our life, that do not belong in our life. We are called to remove those things that weigh us down spiritually, that become a burden on our hearts. And in one of the Old Testament readings this evening, we heard about the righteous Joseph. And we hear about Joseph, and we're familiar with how his brother sold him into slavery, throwing him into a ditch. And we didn't hear that this evening, but what we heard tonight was how Joseph was reunited with his brothers who had done this to him, as we read in the scriptures. This encounter that came many, many years later, and by that time Joseph was now second only to Pharaoh, and had achieved great influence and great stature. And his brothers came to him hoping that he would not recognize them, but would still grant them aid, because they were, and their father were, suffering with famine, and hoping to receive aid from Joseph and from Pharaoh, but not wanting to expose themselves as his brothers, of course, for fear of Joseph seeking revenge and retribution. But Joseph knows who they are and learns who they are. And rather than do what most of us would think someone would do in this situation, scolding them, laying into them, casting them out, punishing them, imprisoning them. I mean, he had the potential, he had the power to do all these things. And yet, he actually consoles his brothers and comforts them by telling them what they did, what actually turned out to be a great benefit to the Hebrew people, because now Joseph could assist them in his position, that what they did turned out to be for good, and he forgives them, and therefore is a type of Christ. Christ, who himself, we know, was sold for 30 pieces of silver. Christ, who went down to the pit of Hades and yet forgives those who did this to him. So Joseph represents a type of Jesus Christ by forgiving the wrong, the great injustice that was done to him, because Joseph, like Christ, did nothing wrong to deserve what fell upon him. And so, my brothers and sisters, we see two very great spiritual truths in this passage. One, to imitate Joseph, who is a type of Christ, and to forgive those who have wronged us, even though what they did was undeserving, even though we may have been completely innocent, we are called to forgive. We are called to forgive. That forgiving does not mean what happened was right, any more than Joseph forgiving his brothers meant that what they did to Joseph was right. But we are called to forgive. And by doing so, my brothers and sisters, a great burden will be lifted from us, because to hold grudges and to withhold forgiveness hurts us as much, if not more so, than those who are trying to hurt by withholding our mercy. So let us experience the peace of God and the relief that comes from forgiving those who have wronged us, but also, and this is also very difficult, to be like Joseph and not to grumble, not to complain, not to say, God, why me? Not to be bitter, resentful, but rather to take whatever comes our way and to accept it and to use it for good. And that's the key. To take whatever challenges and obstacles and tribulations come our way, and to transform it and to use it for good, and to make something good come out of it. And very much like the situation we find ourselves in with this COVID-19, a very terrible thing, and yet you can transform it, the situation, and to make something good out of it. Spend more time with our family, to have quality time with our loved ones, to reprioritize our life so we focus on the things that truly matter and put away all the clutter and all the distractions that fill our life. And I have heard from many people, again, while this is a terrible virus, that they have been able to experience peace and strengthen their relationships. So my brothers and sisters, this beautiful passage from Joseph that we read and his actions, while very difficult indeed to emulate, if we strive to do so with God's help, we'll experience great transformation and great peace in our life. May our Lord strengthen you for being remembered. time of the Holy and Great Lent, which concludes this Friday, is the final day of Holy and Great Lent. Lazarus Saturday, which is this Saturday, we have liturgy at 9:30, preceded by the Orthodox at 8:30. And then, of course, this Sunday, Palm Sunday, 9:30, preceded by the Orthodox. And then we begin Sunday evening, the Holy and Great Week, which we are experiencing in the most unimaginable way. And yet I know, by following along with the services at home, by following along with the text that you are provided, that we still can be transformed, and we will still be walking with the Lord and with Him in His final days on this earth. And so let us be encouraged and be like Joseph. Let us accept the situation and make something good out of it, and continue to rely on Christ and grow closer to Him and to those in our life. May our Lord strengthen all of us for the remaining days of Holy Lent and for the upcoming Holy and Great Week. Amen.